Welcome to Let's Play Baldur's Gate Enhanced Edition Blind. I'm Amethyst Lunatari. I talked about going to some areas south of here.
Looking for goodness.
Like here, I think we have not explored all of that. Don't worry, I'm not going to Duralak's Tower yet. I think it's going to kick our butt at this point. As far as I know here, but I think there's another zone around here. If we go off to one of these edges, south or east, maybe even, well, I think west would take us here, but I'm not sure. But forgot to mention, I want to go to Beregost. Yeah, Beregost.
Squeaky wheel gets the kick.
To get a, what do you call it? Well, we have to identify some items. Sell some items, and I want to collect another fighter for our party. And Kagain is here.
Rest. A bad case of armor, chief.
Ooh, I'm tired.
Yeah, we're gonna sleep. We're gonna sleep. Such is the adventurer's life. It's 12 noon, but we're gonna go to sleep for a while. Right place, fell post, yeah. Before I forget. We have two things to memorize? I mean, not memorize, identify. To memorize, identify four. So, let's see. These two. Yeah, that's it. Okay. Yeah, okay. So we need to find, actually, weapons for Dinah here to use. She has nothing. It's very ill-prepared. She was the captive of Knowles, after all.
Full plate and packing steel.
All right, first to see what he'll buy. Keeping all the potions. Oh, the pearl we didn't put away. All right. You just got arrows. Contaminated iron. He would actually buy her journal for 1 gold. I'm saving this for when we go into a fiery area. I probably won't remember it at that point. The color spray. Shield, we already gave one to her. Magic missile. Larlock's minor drain. Okay. Well, I've got a lot of gold at this point. That's good because we're going to need equipment for her and probably going to buy some equipment for Kagain. Alright, so such a bag. Got all the money. 600. Oh, that wasn't even all of it. Well, this we're gonna keep. Another 200. Sweet. We have 20,000 gold now. Alright, let's get a room.
You want some whiskey?
Noble accommodations. Oh, I think Boo wants another story. Do you know any good stories, Dinah here? Minsk has really run out of them. Thou must surely be joking. I would never relate a tale to a hamster. Please, pretty please, you could tell Boo about that time you went for a swim in the Lake of Dragons, and Orovar stole your clothes and then... Minsk! Thou would not dare to... I mean, 'tis not a proper story for such a young hamster. I would tell him the story of the Princess Swan and her candy castle. Peanut Castle, I think that would interest Boo more. Indeed. So once upon a time, the beautiful princess Sunflower Seed went to a dance to the Sunflower Dale in the Peanut Forest. And one says, Minsk, what was it about Aravar? The Lake of Dragons? It's somewhere in the Dale lands. Isn't that it? Sorry, Boo. Everyone wants to hear about Aravar. Heh, we took the ship, the same ship, to Westgate with Aravar, and he really liked dining here. Minsk! Imoen, I would appreciate if thou would not pester our friend with this. Teach me burning hands, she says. 'Tis not a joking affair. Thou couldst start a forest fire if thou art not careful. So, Minsk, what did Aravar do? On the other hand, thou art quite cautious for a rogue. 'Tis not Hathran's custom to turn away one who is willing to learn. Mayhaps I can be persuaded to teach thee. Promise? Promise. Minsk says, that Aravar, he had a cabin by the Lake of Dragons, and he invited us to stay for a week. And Dinah here, she was so sick that she was unable to travel. And one says, Minsk, I think that Boo'd rather hear the story about Princess Sunflower Seed and the Peanut Castle. I look like another section of dialogue was popping up before this happened, but I only click once. That was funny, though. Okay, so now we can memorize some stuff. Actually, I forgot how to memorize. Did I say memorize again? I forgot how to identify stuff. Alright, this book. Ooh. Tome of Leadership and Influence. One of the most popular recent tomes of leadership and influence is the cynically entitled book, How to Win Friends and Influence People. Like others of its ilk, it peddles a philosophy of personal ascendancy and manipulation by charisma alone. The authors and advocates of such tomes claim that, by drawing on the most recent theories in sociology and interpersonal psychology, it is possible to raise an individual's charisma by a single point. Really? Sweet. I've heard that there are books of a few different stat boosting, properties? What was going with that? In truth, such increases in personal charisma are the product of magical spells placed on the text as it is in the writing process. These same spells also cause the tome to disappear after their first use. An excellent marketing strategy, you must concede. Charisma raised by 1 point permanently. Book is consumed upon use. Usage placed into quick item slot. Really? I guess we use it like an item at that point. What is my charisma? It's 14. But I'm really curious. Like, what if Minsk used it? Would his charisma go up?
Choose your friends wisely. Not all are as trustworthy as Minsk.
Okay, it's not just for the player character. Good to know. Well, I want to increase my own, thank you. Sorry. That's why I did that. So mine is 14. And now 15. Sweet. Awesome. Well, I have another thing to identify as well. And that was a 25-pound book. Magically heavy as well, I guess. The Brawling Hands. Gauntlets of Dexterity. This pair of gauntlets was likely developed in Karatur to aid masters of the martial arts. Legends speak of such masters from the Far East bringing these items with them on their journeys, though details remain sketchy. Alright. You have a dexterity of 18, I guess, no matter what dexterity you have. I wonder if you have a dexterity of greater than 18, if it would bring you down to 18. And, no AC, as far as I can tell. So I'm already wearing Bracers of Defense. Just give me armor class 8. In effect, they give me plus 2 AC as it stands now. Alright, so let's give this to someone else. Vince could use it. This Dale's Protector. Thaco plus 2 with missile weapons, which is great for her because she's always using her arrows. So dexterity. I think that that helps with your armor class as well. Believe it or not, I've got the Baldur's Gate actual manual in front of me. Ability scores. Really, does it go over them each one by one? I don't think this is the original manual that I have, though. I think the first one, the original manual was spiral bound, wasn't it? So I'm gonna look up dexterity here, see if they have a spot in the index. 77. I first talk about it. Dexterity. I know it's your affects your range attack, and I think dexterity affects the character's ability to attack with a missile weapon. Only affects the chances to hit and does not affect the amount of damage. And then they also talk about it here. Okay, here's what I wanted it break down. Character's hand-eye coordination, agility, reflexes, and balance. It is the prime requisite of the thief. And then towards the end, there's something else. One page, bear with me, guys. Oh, character ability scores. Oh, good. This has the modifiers and everything. So I just made my... Okay, this is just strength, dexterity, constitution. It's the AC adjustment. Okay. So she has a dexterity of 16, so if I give it to her, right, of AC adjustment, her AC will go down or will increase, get better, to minus 2, should be with those gauntlets. Gauntlets of dexterity. So armor class is minus 1, armor class is 2. Let me just see something. So armor class still remains minus 2. Oh, is it really doing anything for her, actually? This is Thaco with missile weapon. So this is not increasing her to the point, because she has 16. It says it goes up with 17. AC adjustment. I guess it doesn't. Wait, she's 16. Wait, no, I'm looking at that. Charisma. Dexterity is 18. Sorry, guys. Okay, yeah, so if I put this on, her dexterity is 19, but there's no change with 19 for AC, anyway. This is the Thaco one. Dexterity is still 18. Oh, that's right, because it makes it 18. No, wait, no. Braces at the. I'm back on me. Every time I go back to me. This makes your dexterity 18. Her dexterity is already 18. Right. So that's silly. Okay, so. She is better off having this with the Thaco increase, okay. Boop. So who else, besides me, will be using missile weapons? Probably Dinah here. Once we get her some. This would make her dexterity 18, of course. As opposed to 13, so it should increase her armor class. Nice. Much better. Oh, you know what? I'll give her... I'll just give her this robe. For now, anyway. That's better. Just gives her orange stuff. Orange details. Alright. So that's that. I've spent enough time messing around with this stuff. Wish I could move this. I think we have to take it out of our pack and put it back in. There it is. Will it say anything different if I talk to it? Okay, it pushed me around. It pushed me. Pushed. Alright. How do I put it back in? That's a good question. I thought I could talk to it. Oh, I think I have to go specifically. Oh,
what? Fine.
I'm stuck or something. I don't know. It backs away towards Sapphire. Obviously, it doesn't want to talk to you. I am Sapphire. I'm having trouble pathing in here.
But
let's go back out.
Goodness.
Because I have to put it back in my pack.
Butt kicking for goodness.
It just had me standing around doing nothing when I'm trying to talk to it. Okay, that is not me. This is me.
A simple matter.
How are you? Everything okay down there? So long as you are well, my lady, then I am well. But since you were asking, I could use a snack. Perhaps a nice gopher. Or some pie. Ooh, yes, I like pie. That is not what I wanted. Danger for all who pass this way. Okay, let me just look. Okay, good. Because I wanted it tucked off, not in the middle of everything. So that's why I did that. Let's go rest.
Butt kicking for goodness! Squeaky wheel gets the kick!
Oh, what am I doing? Enemy? Oh, you're still up here? Transig?
Butt kicking for goodness! Full plate and packing
steel. He's still in there, running away from us. Alright, sleep time. Better not bother us while we sleep. Done. Danny here says, "Yes, Branwyn, thou hast kept thine eyes upon me for some time now. What troubles thee?" Ah, yes, well, mageling, that is to say. Though I allow thee some latitude for thine obvious distress, 'twould be more proper, not to mention less insulting, if I were called by my proper name. Thou know'st it, so make use of it. Yes, Dinah here. Have you considered sharpening your, battle skills somewhat? Truly, if it were not for your mints, there were times when you would have been sliced near to shreds. And surely the Knoll incident is not beyond your recall. It just actually kind of came from there. No, 'tis not. Yet Minsk is here by my side now, and will be for the foreseeable future. Thus what my balls of flame cannot handle, his strength of arm surely will. You don't know Fireball yet. And why would I even consider sharpening my battle skills, Priestess of Tempest? Tempest? I have no aptitude for such, and would sooner be willing to take up a well-strung harp. I swear, thou wouldst attempt to train Boo in the wielding of flails if the beast held still long enough. My apologies, Dinah here, but I truly think 'twould be best if you spent just a little more time working on your archery, at least. Tempest has shown me that you cannot always depend on magic, nor on your comrade, stalwart though he be. Mages can't use bows and arrows. I am sure Tempest hath, Priestess. Now grant me a favor. Grant a great favor to me, and still thy lips. No, Dinah here, you do not understand. Tempest has shown me these things. 'Twas in a dream I had of late. I know it sounds like the foolishness of children, barely out of swaddling clothes, but 'twas so very vivid. I dreamt of Minsk in rage, yet helpless, of creatures arrogant and cruel that laughed as your mighty spells rolled off them, as droplets off the back of a waterfowl. I know you do not place your faith where I do, but I cannot believe Tempest would send me this dream if there were no meaning to it. Please do take caution, Dinah here. Though I find your methods of battle less than perfect, I have no wish to see you harmed. Well, I see thou hast some sentiment in thy heart after all, Branwyn. Your dreams are strange things, and oft may be stirred up by nothing more than a bite of undercooked meat or a stressful day, and 'twould appear that every day spent in a band such as this is cause for stress. Still, if it puts thee more at ease, I shall be on my guard. Okay.
Cool one, sir.
On that note,
full plate and packing steel.
It's too late to go to Thunderhammers. I don't have anything else to do here, do I? Extra healing, kind of saving those. Okay. I was looking on the wrong side of everything. I was like, how did I get the potions inside there?
Right. Butt kicking for goodness!
We needed a rest again.
And packing steel.
Just to make it daytime. What?
Squeaky wheel gets the kick!
Yeah, we have to go there to buy some stuff. Actually, we should talk to Kagain first. Well, I'm thinking about it. Kagain shop here. We have a slot open!
Kicking for goodness!
Get out of my store! You're not wanted here unless, of course, you've changed your mind about my previous offer. Okay, we'll take up your offer. We need another warrior in our party anyhow. That's good. I've been having a lot of problems with bandit activity lately, but they've always only taken the cargo and let the caravan go afterward. I've been catching flack from the family of some of the passengers of this caravan. After all, it was the job of my mercenaries to make sure everyone got safely to Baldur's Gate. Normally I wouldn't give one damn about some stupid whiner, but one of the passengers was the son of Entar Silvershield. And in this part of the world, his word is law. So, do you want the job or not? We have a fibula of Eddard Silvershield, I believe, is his name. Sure, as soon as you tell us how much we'd be paid. I'll pay 15 gold per head, as well as equal opportunity to loot any of the dead bodies the bandits may have left behind. Sure. Hey, I'm glad you guys have some sense in your heads. I have an underling who can take care of business here while I'm gone, so let's get a move on. And that was it. Are they all different things, or is it just different ways of putting forth the fibula? Well, there is sure is trouble on the roads. We battled a bandit group that had just killed everyone in a caravan up north. Any chance this pin was from one of yours? Well, this is Silvershield's son's marker. Dead, you say? That was one of my caravans. Guess I'm in a lot of trouble now. With him dead, I'll be a wanted dwarf. Well, since my reputation is now mud, how about I help you gain revenge on those scumbags? Perhaps you can put in a word for me with the Silver Shields. What do you say? Sure, we could use your skills. Level up, Kagain. Entar Silver Shield's son was killed. We might take the pin back to his family when we get to Baldur's Gate. Okay, he's not even here in town. What you got? Okay, he's got studded leather armor, a helmet, a battle axe, and a medium shield. Aha! He's lawful evil. Oh boy. I'm not sure if he's gonna last that long in this group, to tell you the truth. Alright, so 16 strength, 12 dexterity, 20 constitution. Wow, yeah, well, dwarves have really good constitution. Intelligence 15, wisdom 11, charisma 8. Less even than Minsk. Well, Minsk has his own special charisma. When asked about his past, Kagain stresses that the questioner should just mind their own business. They want to keep their teeth. It's apparent that he runs a rather shady mercenary company, and that he's quite obsessed with wealth. But any information beyond this, he is content to keep to himself. It's a rather short biography compared to the others. Let's level him up. Well, he already has some proficiency slots in axe. I guess we'll keep. Should we keep that going? Flail, Morningstar, or crossbow for minor ones. Alright. No, we need some kind of magical axe. So he's level 5 now. Caught up with the rest of us. Awesome. See what he might have to say.
Such menial tasks.
He seems less aggravated than usual. Now would be a good chance to find out something about him. You are used to hearing things from the bottom of people's hearts, so you try to charm Kagain into telling you more about himself. I'll not to tell you twice to mind your own business. Well, that didn't work. You're a close-mouthed fellow, Kagain. Any thoughts on things in general? Buy cheap and sell dear is good. Killing them and looting their bodies for free ain't bad, though. How are things with you in the front line, Kagain? Kinda lonely, tell you the truth. You should try it up here yourself once in a while. Once or twice. I don't have friends, so I don't get why you suddenly come into my life. Well, friends, if I had something to tell you, I would. But I don't.
Full plate and packing steel.
Okay, so he is like gonna be up on the front lines here. Get the mages in the middle. Works for me. Okay. So I want to see if I can get him some plate mail.
Full plate and packing steel.
Ah, it's raining, damn it. Here. And we're just cutting through there. Okay, I guess that's shorter. Everybody remember who your buddy is.
Squeaky wheel gets the kick.